Neurons in our nervous system use electrical impulses to transmit information throughout our bodies. This process is mediated by membrane proteins called voltage-gated ion channels. Voltage-gated ion channels open and close in reaction to changes in membrane voltage or membrane potential. A cell membrane potential is generated by concentration gradients of positively charged sodium and potassium ions across the membrane. When a neuron is at rest, its ion channels are closed, and the overall concentrations of ions and proteins create a higher potential on the outside and a lower potential on the inside. This state is referred to as resting potential, and the membrane is said to be polarized. To transmit a signal, the neuron creates an action potential which travels down the axon. The action potential is mediated by the opening of the voltage-gated sodium channels, which allows sodium to enter the neuron. This depolarizes the membrane in that local area. Neurons then repolarize the membrane in several ways. First, voltage-gated sodium channels close and become inactivated. Then, to counteract the positive charge of the sodium ions, potassium channels open to allow potassium ions to exit, lowering the voltage across the membrane. In this way, the signal travels along the neuron. Sodium channels open and trigger one another to generate action potentials, and potassium channels prime the neuron for the next signal by allowing potassium to exit. After the signal has finished, the locations of ions have been reversed. Sodium concentration is high on the inside, and potassium concentration is high on the outside. The sodium and potassium pump restores the sodium and potassium gradients, making the cell ready to send another signal. With each pumping cycle, this transport protein moves two potassium ions back into the cell and three sodium ions out of the cell. Because the pump moves these ions against their concentration gradients, it requires the energy of one ATP molecule for each cycle. This molecular machine comprises three chains, alpha, beta, and gamma. Within the alpha chain, three domains, A, P, and N, form the core engine of the pump. The pumping cycle occurs in several steps. With ATP bound in the N site and the transmembrane region open into the cell, the pump binds three sodium ions from the cytoplasm. This causes the N, P, and A sites to shift closer together. With the help of a magnesium cofactor, the P site is phosphorylated and ADP is cleaved off. This leads to a conformational change that exposes the sodium ions to the outside. The sodium ions can then be released, one after another, into the extracellular space. In this ion-empty state, the pump allows the entry of two potassium ions. This causes dephosphorylation of the pump followed by closing of the extracellular gate, and allows the N domain to accept ATP again. As a result of ATP binding, the intracellular gate opens, the potassium ions are released into the cytoplasm, and the cycle can start again. The sodium-potassium pump is a key protein that works to maintain the sodium-potassium gradients and intra- and extracellular potential differences necessary for neuronal signaling. Roughly a third of the ATP made daily by our cells is spent to power this molecular machine.